Examining the intact iris in the eye, you should see a ring of dark fibrous tissue surrounding the area where the lens was removed. In order to get a closer look at the structure of the iris, using your blunt probe, you can begin to loosen it from the surrounding tissue of the eye. In order to keep the iris intact, the best approach is to start in the center and work your way out with the blunt probe. Once you are able to get the probe completely under the iris, use it to slowly lift a portion of the iris away from the wall of the eye. Once the lifted portion is large enough, you can use your fingers to slowly remove the rest of the iris. If done carefully, the iris can be removed completely intact. Removed from the eye, we can now see the whole structure of the iris, including the pupil and the surrounding muscle. Examining the rear half of the eye that you set aside earlier, the first thing that should be immediately apparent is the thin membrane covering the eye wall. This membrane is very delicate and comprises the retina at the back of the eye. Placing the vitreous humor back in the eye on top of the retina can help illustrate its original position within the eye. With the vitreous humor removed, the blind spot is one structure of the retina that can be easily identified. Look for folds in the retina membrane where it appears to disappear into the wall of the eye. This spot corresponds with the blind spot and also the optic nerve on the outside back of the eye. Another structure to note on the retina which may or may not be visible in your specimen is the fovea. This is a small depression in the retina which is located near the blind spot. When compared to the rest of the surrounding retina, the fovea has a unique proportion of rods and cones.